Howdy ding dong doody guys, welcome back to Let's Play The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, I got my ass kicked by Wolfie McFuckface over there. And oh my goodness, I was on an absolute rampage. I was debating if I should go outside and start tipping over cars and shit, because I just went Hulk smash mode. Apologies if you think that was harsh. I do tend to get a bit angry with just shit like that. But, I'm going to be doing something different today. I've let that werewolf beat me into a pulp far too many times to go give it another go. I just think I need better gear and essentially a way to better knock its health down and overcome the regeneration that it's got, because that's absolutely ridiculous. So, apologies, crones of Crookback Bog, but I'm going to go do something else, because your quest absolutely sucks. I mean, these all-powerful witches that can see everything that's going on in Velen and send people to their doom if they say bad things against them next to a tree. A werewolf. Sorry, we're not having anything to do with that. Right, okay, let's go find the Baron's daughter in Oxenfurt. Where's Oxenfurt? That's still here, isn't it? Oxenfurt. Yeah, it's miles up the road. Okay, so I'll have to fast travel to the hangman's tree and then take it from there. I can still hear a werewolf in the distance just laughing at me. You suck. Oh, God. Well, I guess some of you tuned in just to see me get my absolute ass handed to me and not have an easy ride. But, yes. Oh, yeah, that's right. Spawn me next to Tweedledee and Tweedledon't over there. Whatever that is. Right, Roach. Let's go get stuck into something else. I could really do with a shave in this game, I'm not going to lie. Is that a possibility in this game? Can you go touch up Geralt's appearance? Because he's looking a bit grisly, isn't he? His hair's a bit of a mess. His beard's all over the place. It looks like he's been dragged through a thorny hedge. I guess some people like that look. I need a bath. Right, okay, let's get on over to Oxenfurt then and find this Tamara person, since apparently... Whoa. What's going on here?
What's going on here? Why isn't anyone putting that out?
We want it to burn. Got it?
Piss off, or we'll fry you along with a fucking elf!
And you can't just burn people alive.
There's a third way out of this situation.
Oh, start dodging, Geralt, come on. You've just been fighting a werewolf and you can't even deal with these idiots. I'm dealt with. Okay, let's get all this guy's shit so we can sell it on. I also got a repair kit. Alright, what on earth is going on in here, guys? Hang on, let me just... Mind the door!
Fast.
Yeah, I'm not just gonna let them kill an innocent person, am I? It was really none of my concern, but seriously, that'd just be absolute cruelty.
What was this about? Why'd they want to burn you alive?
They came to rob me. I refused to betray where I keep my valuables, so they brought in a cart full of firewood, barred me inside, and set fire to the thing.
Probably counting on you being swayed. Though I doubt they would have let you live even if you'd talked.
I've yet to thank you for your aid, Vatgern. My coin lies concealed in a hollowed-out stump behind the house. Take what you wish. It's dangerous to possess too much in these times.
Thank you. Farewell.
Oh, you need to build a new house now. Snaps out outrage. Right, okay, let's jump over here and get to the hollowed out tree behind my house. This thing. Right. Let's go through here. Oh well, there we go. Take what you want. She made that sound like you could just like be nice. You know, take 10, leave her 10. No, I'm taking it all. My kindness must be paid for. Wait, where's the game taking me here? Wait, what? Why is it switch quests? Hell, using the Albitcher sensors. Why is it done that? Like, I don't want. The game's really trying my patience today.
Slower.
Same way, innit? Right, let's go do this shit. Put the sword away, Geralt. There's nothing here. Right. There's a nest over there, so I don't think I want anything to do with that for the moment being. Already enough dealing with monsters in the wilderness for one day. Right, okay. Come on. Yes, I'm really starting to feel the difficulty of this game now, and it's kind of frustrating once I'm like spending, you know, 1 hour on one 20-minute episode. It drives me bonkers. Why is the game doing this to me? Oh, I guess we're already there. Well, this place looks inviting. Excuse me, guy with whatever it is that you're carrying. Hello.
Slow now.
Right, okay, I think I need to get across the bridge to get into the town, don't I?
Rock.
Okay. Is this where I'm going to try and get in? They're going to be like, no, you killed our guys. Even though it was burning down a house. I mean, it's ridiculous. You can't just come and burn houses down and expect...
Stay out of my way.
You can't expect no one to do anything about it. I'd be absolutely bananas. Well, this looks like a more built-up civilized place, doesn't it? It's like a proper London township. Oh, London town.
Halt! No passage.
But why?
In case of the plague surface in the city or something.
The plague? No. We're to not let folk in the city. It's an order, so I don't. Unless someone's got a pass.
Do I have a pass?
This way, you mean?
Let me look at that. Missing a seal, the red one.
Impossible.
Department of Civil Defense forgot me. They're really off their heads these days. Happens, so be it. You may come through.
Oh, what a nice bloke. I guess he wouldn't have let me in if he realized that I was a huge arsehole.
In a hurry.
Yes, I am in a hurry. In settled areas such as cities, villages, and camps, paths tend to be narrow and obstacles numerous. Yeah, maximum movement speed in these places is limited. That's fair enough, I suppose. You don't want to be really sprinting through streets. It'd ruin the immersion. Oh, wow. I'm sure this place would be beautiful if it wasn't banging it down with rain. Goddamn changeable weather conditions. Ooh, a barber's! Yes, I could do with one of those. Can I get in there? Hello? Look at me, I'm a bit of a mess at the minute.
Greetings, master. What can I do for you?
Got a razor and shears? Good. Make me look decent.
There you go. I'd like you to style my beard. A bushy goatee. Want a mustache? Just clean shaven. And what about hair? I don't think I want to interfere with Geralt's hair too much, do I? Shaved except for a ponytail, long and loose. No, the hair will do. Thank you.
So long.
Looking a little better now. Yeah, that'll do. Okay, let's get on out of here. Nice little customization options, which, you know, it's true to Geralt's character that he'd probably have a few odd haircuts here and there, and it doesn't, like, give you at maximum customization. Like, I want a Mad Max mohawk. Sorry. Alright, let's look at this notice board. No, notice boards. Use it. There we go. Use. Right, a troll's been seen. A troll. Cool. Right, so I've got some new quest there. So I've got stuff to be leveling up with. So thankfully, this city looks like a nice, decent quest hub. Right, okay. But I get, is that troll got infinite regeneration health as well? Right, how do we get in here? Sorry, boy.
Boy.
Nice for doors on the other side. Here we go.
I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Wojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
Hello, kitten. They don't like witches, do they?
You're looking for me, and who might you be? My father send you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive, and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
I don't blame you.
Your father's a vile man. You're angry and bitter. Can't blame you.
Why do you help him then? Why did you take this job?
Because he knows something about someone dear to me. Promised to tell me if I found you and your mother.
Got it. A bit of blackmail. Just his style. Well, now you've found me, you can tell him I'm alive and I'm never coming back.
That's a bit of a direct question, so I want to avoid that. I'll start by
before I agreed to
letting
you,
her tell me to my side
me
of the story.
Version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19 and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line and we fled.
What happened to your mother?
Wojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands, and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
I don't want to ask the direct question about miscarry. I think that's going to have something to do with her husband being a massive knobhead. But what will she do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
Who are these friends?
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
And your father?
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him.
Ha ha ha, savage.
I won't go back to him. That bit of my life. Forgotten it already.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good.
Let me guess your name. Down. Gaston.
desperate fathers have been known to do a lot to find their daughters.
Unexpected from a witcher. I thought your mutations cleansed you of humanity. Stripped you of emotions.
You don't need mutations to strip men of their humanity. I've seen plenty of examples.
And who are you?
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Gradon, witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamora, she can make her own decisions.
Oh, you got a cold there, friend.
A killer for hire abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you.
Where are you going to take her?
Tamora must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding a mother.
Hope you know what you're getting into.
I've never been more certain. The Eternal Fire is the best thing that could happen to me.
In that case, good luck.
Thank you for respecting my choice. Farewell.
Alright, this is going to lead us to a dead end with the Baron, isn't it? The cat's called Nibbles! That's awesome! Alright, okay. Tamora Stringer. Alright, okay, so now what do I do? I think... Let's go take a look at the quests that we've got. Investigate all remaining leads in Velen and find the Baron's wife. Okay. So what do I need to do there then? I think I need to let the game update for a little bit. Yeah, the quest updated. There's nothing for me here. I think I need to wait a few days before I continue on with that. I'm not of suitable level to kill that bloody werewolf. Blech. So let's go on to some secondary quests then. Fjölnir Pyres. Are all these in Velen? Yeah, let's go... Velen then. Deep in the swampy woods of Velen, there is a roadside altar praising the glories of one of the forgotten gods. That is where Geralt encountered a shriveled half-senile old man who claimed he could foretell the future and would read Geralt's fortune. First Morphe. That costs money! No. Alright. In No Man's Land, Geralt was given a contract by an Eternal Fire priest. His task? To burn the bodies of soldiers who have fallen during the recent battle in order to keep necrophages from eating them. And do I have them marked on my map? I do, so let's fast travel on over to Mulberry Dale and go get stuck into these quests. In the next video, because I'm out of time for this one, so thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.